A very good morning to my dear students. This is your English teacher, Mrs. Astha Gulati, and this is the video number 1 of chapter number 8, children, Adventure with Dilly. In this first video, children, we are going to do the summary, and you please place your books in front of you so that you can understand the chapter better. So we will start with the summary from the chapter number 8, page number 76. Starting with the chapter, children, the summary, I would like to ask you where you would like to go with your parents for a holiday. Have you gone? Have you had an adventure anytime? Yes, most of you must have enjoyed a lot with your family in your holidays and went to do some adventure to certain places, many places. So here is a story, children, of a brother and a sister. They both thought that their parents do not want to do adventure or they are very boring. But here comes an idea when the mother said that she would be going to a certain place for some work and the family can join her. And they will do much, they will enjoy the vacation or the holiday and they can spend time together. Here is a story where they enjoyed a lot with the family. Let's begin with the chapter. It was a Saturday, nestled in a rocking chair on a balcony. Krish was reading the travel and leisure section of the newspaper. Krish was the boy, children, who was sitting in the balcony on a rocking chair and reading the section. There are many sections in the newspaper, children, where you have different topics. And he was reading about travel and leisure time. And Pranita, his sister, was solving a Sudoku puzzle in the living room. Sudoku puzzle, children, it's a sort of a puzzle where you get it from the market and it's very knowledgeable. You just make, you learn many things from the puzzle. So, they were doing and let's see what happens. Krish came to her. Krish, the boy, came to her. To whom? To Pranita, and said, let's ask dad to take us somewhere so that we can also have some adventure. He wanted to have an adventure with the family. He wanted to enjoy a holiday. And take us to Andaman Islands. He wanted to go to the Andaman Islands where he wanted to go. He must have wanted to go to a seaside to enjoy water and the rides you have in water. Water rides, you can say. Islands this winter. In the winter holidays, he wanted to go Andaman Islands. She gave him a hard stare. Hard stare, children, means the stern stare. That she was very serious about it. She thought that how was it possible when their parents did not like to do adventure. She gave him a hard stare. Pranita said when Krish asked her that let's ask dad to go on a vacation, then Pranita said about dad that he said to him that how he knows how dad is. He knows about dad means he knows that he doesn't want to do any adventure. He was a simple man with no adventure in life, and he was very regular with his work, going to the office and coming back. So she said, and Krish was very disappointed. He was very disheartened listening to this, that Pranita, his sister, said about dad that he will not go. What should I say to him? He will not go anywhere. It's waste. So later in the evening, what happened? The family, when father came back from the office, the mother was also free. When they sat together on the dinner table, talking about all the day's events, what happened with you and what happened with Krish, your mother, the father, everything. Everybody was discussing the day. So Mrs. Sinha, the mother, said, I have got interesting news. She got an interesting news. What was the news, children? Everyone looked at her with eager faces. They did not go anywhere. Everywhere. The children want children. We all need a vacation, a holiday with our family. So Krish and Pranita also wanted to go outside. Outside means out of the town to enjoy their vacation. And when the mother, Mrs. Sinha, said that she had an interesting news, everybody was looking at her with certain faces, with eager faces. They wanted something good to happen now. Let's see what was the good news. Good news was she was going to Swarajdeep to inspect the marine project. Marine project means, children, what do you mean by marine? Marine means of or relating to the sea. Marine means when somebody inspects the projects or the, you know, oil projects and everything comes from sea down towards. So she was inspecting a marine project and she had to go to the Swaraj Dweep, and she asked the family whether they wanted to join her there. So I do, Mr. Sinha, and the children chorused. I do means everybody was very excited listening to this and they wanted to join and go to Swaraj Dweep with Mrs. Sinha. That's settled. That settled means, children, that settled means that's final. We are going. Everybody is going with me. We will leave next Sunday. And when they were going, they were going on the next Sunday. Sunday, the family reached the Swaraj Dweep and settled into a comfortable guest house where everybody was comfortable. They liked the room and it was a guest house with a view of a brilliant blue sea. With a view of a brilliant blue sea means there was a guest house and in front of the guest house there was beautiful sea scenery in front of the guest house. Wherever you go, children, in Andaman or Lakshadweep Islands, I have also visited one of them. So we can see the guest houses are just opposite to the sea, and whenever you come out of the room you can view the beautiful blue sea, green, light green sea, and you can enjoy rides also. So it was a beautiful view for them. Close to the beach, Krish squealed with delight, and when he saw, Krish saw that they were just so near to the sea, to from the guest room, the guest house, he was very delighted. He was very happy to see, after so long, or for the first time maybe, he was coming out with his family and enjoying this beautiful place. Let's go for a swim. Maybe some dolphins are waiting for us. Krish, he was so excited. He wanted to just jump into the water and he asked anybody wanted to go with him to do swimming. And he was also waiting that you can see dolphins also on the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, children. There are dolphins also, and there must be a season. It should be a winter season to go there. The children raced to the water. Just then they heard a shrill whistle. The children went towards the water. They could not wait. They were so excited. And they heard a shrill whistle means, a shrill sound, children, a shriek, a loud sound is called a shrill sound. Okay, the whistle was very, very piercing, very, very loud. And someone was coming towards them. Who was coming towards them? Hi, I'm Ravi, guide and the lifeguard for the guest here. And there is a person, children, who guides you when you go towards the sea. He was the guide for the guest house. All the members or all the guests who comes for the work, maybe, for the company who hosts you. There is a lifeguard who assists you when you go towards the sea and makes you very comfortable in the water. He guards you and sees that you are very safe. So he was Ravi. He was the lifeguard for the guests. Do you know how to swim? He asked. And first thing what the guard asked was, do you know? He was asking Krish and Pranita, the children, whether they know how to swim or not. Yes, we were hoping to see some dolphins here. Are there any? Pranita asked. And when he asked something without answering his question, Pranita asked him another question, whether they can see dolphins on the beach. He did not answer to this question. Just what he did, he whistled again. Why did he whistle? When Pranita and Krish saw here and there, nobody was here. So why was he whistling? There's no one else here. Why did you whistle again? Krish asked curiously. He was very eager to know. Why did he whistle? Without answering the question, why is he whistling? Ravi smiled. You will see in a moment. Moment means, children, just now, just you can see what will happen when I whistle, he said. Look there. He pointed towards some bottlenose dolphins leaping and doing acrobatic spins. And they were, the dolphins were very they were very close to Ravi, and when they whistled, it was the sign for the dolphins to come out and do acrobatics. means they were moving, they were doing different things. Acrobatic means difficult movements of the body like jumping, swimming. You can see on the Google also, children. Dolphins are very trained animals. They can be trained, they can dance with you, they can make you ride on themselves. They're very good animals. So when Ravi whistled, they came out and started doing acrobatic spins. Those are my friends, Dilly and her delightful babies. Who were the dolphins? Ravi said that the dolphin was her very close friend, and she was Dilly. The dolphin's name was Dilly, and she had many delightful babies. Delightful baby means happy babies, she said. Ravi said, Krish and Pranita were thrilled. Krish and Pranita, they were very excited now. They were very thrilled and they were waiting for the adventure to happen, the adventure to start. Krish was super excited. He was unable to speak, children. He was unable. Now, when Krish was very excited, he was unable to speak. He did not have words. So, after that, Ravi asked them whether they have permission to go into deep waters to do what? To swim with the dolphins. They have to go to the deeper waters where the dolphins are there. So Pranita quickly called her dad. Dad is asking us to wait. Dad, Pranita called her dad to ask whether they could go to the deeper water, the father said to wait, and Pranita's face fell. Means she was sad that she had to wait and father was not listening to her. Mr. Sinha arrived in shorts and t-shirt. He was wearing a shorts and a t-shirt, and he was also ready for swimming into the deep waters and playing with the dolphins. He started chatting with Ravi. He might be talking about what they will do or what are the activities they could do in the water. Is he going to swim with us? Who's asked? Krish whispered to Pranita. It was unbelievable for the children to believe that father also wanted to enjoy. Don't know, they said. They got into a speedboat and headed out to the sea. Now, everybody talked about they have to go to the deep waters, and now they sat on a boat and headed towards the sea. Ravi shut off the engine and blew his whistle. And when they reached the place, particular place where they could find dolphins, they stopped the boat and Ravi blew the whistle again. Why? To call the dolphins. He dropped an anchor into the water. What is an anchor, children? To hold on the sea. The boat will go on and on. It will float on the water. But to hold the water, there is an anchor which is fell into the water to stop the boat. So, he dropped an anchor into the water to keep the boat from drifting away from the place. It should not float anymore. So, to stop the boat, they dropped an anchor. And her playful cubs. The dolphin's baby is also called a calf, children. Calf. And when it is plural, it is C-A-L-V-E-S, calves. Appeared. And when he whistled, Ravi whistled. And again, the bottlenose dolphins appeared. And the mother was Dilly with her delightful little calves, children. They splashed water on them and made giggling sounds. What did, when Dilly appeared with her little children, what did they do? They splashed water on Pranita, Krish and everyone. They also made giggling sounds. The dolphins are very interesting animals, children. They can giggle also. They can understand your instructions. They are very, very much interesting. She is saying hello to all of you. And Ravi could understand the body language of the dolphin. And he said that Dilly is saying hello to you all. Ravi said, Dilly made a number of kickling sounds. She made a number of kickling sounds, means a certain sound made by a dolphin. I know, line up here, he said. Ravi said, to line up to play with them. And the dolphins put their snouts on the edge of the boat. Ravi pulled out a bucket of fish from under a seat. And when they made kickling sounds, what was the reason? Why were they making so much sound? because they were hungry and they wanted some fish. And so Ravi said that he knows. He was saying to wait and make a line so that he could feed them. And he just took out a bucket of fish and fed the dolphins. Can I feed them? Dad immediately asked Ravi. And what did Dad say? Can I also feed the dolphins? Yes, three each. And it was counted, the fish was counted, and Ravi told the father, Mr. Sinha, to feed three fish to each of them. Dad promptly put the fish into the cups. Means the dolphins opened their mouth and Mr. Sinha was feeding them again and again. So then patted them on the head. After feeding them, Mr. Sinha patted them. Means patting. He was patting on the head of the dolphins. Dad Dilly made loud clicking noises. And now when Ravi and his Mr. Sinha fed them, they made more loudly. They were making clicking sounds. And this time it was much louder. In approval and swam around. They were swimming around them. Splashing water on them. She is inviting you into the water. And now they were very happy. They were full stomach. And now they were calling the children and Mr. Sinha, everyone, into the water to play with them. When Dad now had a grin on his face. On a grin means wide smile on his face. And he said that he was wet in water, drenched in water. And he might now go into the water to have fun with the dolphins. So Dad was now wanting to go into the water. The children were very surprised to see that. Because they had an idea that Dad did not want to do any of the adventures. And he was a simple man. He was a very serious man. But when he said that I wanted to dive into the water, to swim into the water with the dolphins, the children were very surprised. Pranita said, and she didn't know that Mr. Sinha wanted to swim into the water and play with the dolphins. So what now Ravi, listening to that, Ravi said that fun was not only for kids. It can be, the elders can also have fun. And then Dilly swam under and gently lifted him onto her back. And now what happened, children? The dolphins were also playing with them. And now what Dilly, the mother dolphin, what she did, she picked up and put Mr. Sinha on her back. You can see in the picture also, children. And she lifted him up and the children laughed to see their father sitting on a dolphin. Of course, that will be fun, children. It's very enjoyable. Pranita quickly took her out her phone and started clicking pictures. As Dad posed, come on in, you both are expert swimmers. Now, Dad also wanted the children to come into the water. And he said they are expert swimmers and they can also come into the water. And Krish and Pranita was wanting to have this turn or wanting to have this come into the water. And as Dad said, they promptly came into the water and had so much fun swimming with Dilly and her beautiful family. Fun was not only for children, but the adults also want to enjoy with you. But we have certain work that we could not enjoy always. So you all think that we cannot enjoy, but it's not like that. We also want to enjoy, but we are stuck somewhere in work. So it's not possible always. So here we come to the end of the summary, children. In the next video, we are going to do the chapter explanation. I hope you all are keeping well and studying at home. I hope to see you soon, children. We all are missing you. So thank you and have a good day.